Announcement. Well done. You're through to the next program.
Yes, send him through, would you?
Blimey, if your secretary was my daughter, I'd still be bumping her.
Thank you, John. Good to see you. Take a seat.
What can I do for you, Tony?
Well, John, it's a sort of image thing, really. Sorry to keep harping on about it, but you're still not looking terribly, you know, New Labour.
I've got a tie on.
I know, and that's good. And, you know, nice touch. But what did you think about the whole wearing trousers suggestion that we talked about?
Well, I've been talking about it with the wife.
Right.
Now, I wouldn't say my wife was fat.
Anyway, I won't keep you. You carry on considering the trousers question in your own time. You probably just need to get back to your office. What are you working on at the moment?
I'm organising this year's Gay and Lesbian Asian Awareness Week.
Good.
Welcome back. Des here, itching to show you my impressively huge package of sporting highlights. Joining me are Tony Green. Tony.
Des.
And Tony Gubber.
Des. You know, sport's a funny thing.
Sure, Tony. A lot of big laughs in table tennis. And just take a look over here, too. It's the weather girl off Channel 5. Hi.
It's just 5 now, Des.
Whatever. I watched your forecast last night. Hot, humid, sticky.
I forecast sleet.
I know. Back to the sport now. Let's go live to Cleethorpe Civic Hall and professional wrestling. You ever done any wrestling? Like mud.
Welcome back here live for this long-awaited main event tag team bout. Referee Michael Vaughan will have his work cut out keeping order of this one. Kendo Nagasaki entering the ring. There's his nemesis, feared by opponents, loved by the fans, the all-time great man Haystacks. And it looks as though here Haystacks' tag partner Big Daddy is keen to get in the ring. A tag is taken. Oh, but it's not Big Daddy. Kendo can't believe it. It's Henry VIII of England, who for a long time has been keen to prove himself in this division. At this weight, he's looking totally unintimidated. Now, that surely has got to be against the regulations. The referee will have to do something here. And yes, that's going to be a disqualification. It's Haystacks back in, but attack from Kendo too. Agent Smith out of the Matrix. Quite unprecedented, a Matrix seepage seems to have taken place. Agent Smith to face Giant Haystacks. A clash of styles, certainly, but oh my word! Oh, now the last time this happened was Cat Weasel against Rollerball Rocco in 1978. The fans love it, but a duplication to infinity will take this bout. It's back to you, Des.
So there we have it. Just a few notes for you. Remember, wrestling defines all logic and reason, and the architect knows this. Wrestlers are disconnected from the system. We don't know why, except that machines follow their program, and Agent Smith is programmed to kill. Giant Haystacks cannot kill humanity. It's against his program. Zion, the prophecy, and Kendo Nagasaki are all products of the Matrix. The architect is not God. I am. I am the one. Good night.
Are you ready for bed, Ian?
Ah, Mother. Yes, that'll be a book. It's bedtime, isn't it?
Yes, Ian. Now, can you tell me what that is?
It's the letter A, first letter of the alphabet, one of the five vowels.
Very good. Now, look at these pictures and tell me which one is the odd one out. Is it cow, sheep, pig or donut?
Ah, yes. Now, this is a corporate sponsorship question, isn't it?
No.
Is the donut the only one not to receive a large EU subsidy?
No.
Is it something to do with Peter Mandelson?
No. I'm going to have to pass this one over to your brother. No, sorry, it's the donut. All the others live on a farm.
Damn, so obvious now.
Well, never mind. Look at these words and see if you can fill in the gap. The cat sat on the...
Commission of Inquiry.
No.
Parliamentary Committee.
No, the cat sat on the...
Results of the independent scientific test because it didn't want anyone to know it had been lying.
No.
Board of a major merchant bank which it failed to disclose in the register of members' interests.
No, the answer is Matt.
Damn, so obvious now.
Let's try another one. The cow goes moo and the duck goes...
Into bankruptcy.
No.
Into a lucrative legal career.
The duck goes...
Off to run the BBC. Is it something to do with Peter Mandelson?
No. I think that's it for tonight's reading, Ian. Night-night.
Night-night. Can I ask you a question?
Yes, Ian.
When is my mother coming back? I'm getting tired of these guest mothers.
Oh, never mind. It's Bruce Forsyth tomorrow night.
Oh, good. That'll be ironic.
Next on ITV1, Russell Crowe's Master and Commander, The Far Side of the Channel. Somebody get Ozzy's lead.
I'm Captain Jack Orby from His Majesty's Navy.
Welcome on board, sir.
Mr. Cole. Well, sir, the repute of your valour is spread far and wide. Gentlemen, we have a crucial mission ahead of us, which shall not be for the wastrel nor for the faint of heart. We must sail yonder some 15 miles due south onto the coast of France. Once there, we shall have but one purpose. To get 12 crates of Stella, 600 Embassy Super Kings, and some Ferrero Rocher for the wife. Are you with me?
Aye, aye.
Mr. McCulloch, follow your course. Gentlemen, the men at your stations. I wish to know the rate of exchange between early 19th century half-sovereigns and the euro. Damn Galapagos natives, you speak not a word! An ounce of salted beef, two ship's biscuits alive with weevils, and a skinny latte.
Don't worry about it, we'll get
it sorted. Great Scott! Women on board! My dears, you take your lives in your hand being aboard a ship like this. Some of these men haven't seen a woman in more than 9 months. You could be ravaged and despoiled in wanton acts of animal lust. Where do you come from?
Ashford.
Then you shall be used to it, my dear. Enemy vessel! All hands on deck! As she bears, fire! Land ahoy! The port of Calais lies not half a mile hence. Prepare your trolleys! Prepare those big stripy bags you get in laundrettes! The booze and fags await us! You, sir, give us some grog. Some old-fashioned grog that can sink a grown man to his knees with a single slap. An extra measure of rum for you, sir.
Bonjour, monsieur.
Been a fine companion aboard this mission, sir. I shall send a communique to the Lord Admiral, advising him of your courage and determination. Your lordship. Lord Shop? Damn predictive text.
Gentlemen! Though we be all far from home, this ship is home. This ship is England. Let us sing together the anthem of our nation.
Here we go, here we go.
Oh dear.
What in Blunkett's name are you doing?
Well, in a very real...
I demand an explanation for this intrusive and disruptive behaviour.
Well, as part of an extensive revitalisation programme, key pictures such as this are being relocated from loft to lounge, but with the insubstantial nature of these partitions in mind, I pledge to knock less vigorously with my little hammer in the future.
Is that the darkness?
They rock.
No, they don't. I must request that my right honourable next-door neighbour desist from these activities and give me an opportunity to respond without this unseemly barracking. As Chancellor, I am more aware than anyone that these unexpected crashes do sometimes occur, but I seek the Prime Minister's guarantee that he will do all feasible to provide a prompt, practical and prudent solution to this unexpected deficit in the integrity of the dividing wall.
My actions were based on intelligence available at the time. Had I known this DIY intelligence was simply downloaded from the Changing Rooms website and only applied to MDF, I would have acted differently.
I'll Changing Rooms website you in a minute.
But history will judge that I did the right thing.
Well, I judge you had better get down to B&Q pretty sharpish and replace my newly knackered anaglypta.
I think you'll find that this wallpaper is Nova Mura. We can only do our best.
Oh, well, this is incredible, okay? Amazing. Ooh, don't know what to say. Thank a lot of people. Ooh. Ooh. Oh, another one. It's like, ooh. Ooh, he likes it. I can't compete with that.
That's all from part one. Join us when we come back when we'll be asking the Chuckle Brothers, just where are those responsible? Rumble, young man, rumble. Welcome back. Coming up, Jordan lays an egg. We've got the footage. But first, this.
Back to football now. England's European Cup campaign. We can go straight over to everyone's favourite even-tempered Swede, Sven Gollum Eriksson.
The master.
Hello, Sven.
Don't hit us, we love stays.
Now, Sven, I know this has been a problem before and it's going to be hard work out in Portugal this summer. How will you and the players relax between games?
Sven Goll not relax. Sven Goll work hard for England. Help them get through the first group stage. Help them get
the precious horrid England's. Portugal no place for work. Portugal sunny beaches, fresh fishes and ladies in swimwear is for kisses.
Well, I know you've got an eye for the ladies, but after all your troubles before, I'm sure you won't be straying from Nancy's side again in a hurry, will you?
No, I will not. Nancy trusts us. Nice Mrs. Nice Nancy. We love brunettes.
No, blondes. Lovely blondes. Horrid Nancy stops us having blondes on the side with their lovely long blonde hairs and their blue Swedish eyes. Yes, like your precious.
Know what you mean? Check out my chief correspondent, he'll be bringing in some late results later.
Precious.
A tiny, wizened, twisted, misshapen little grey fellow after my own heart there. Limited edition strawberry matchmakers.
I guess I was into the dark arts from the first day of my life. In fact, I'm so magic I wasn't even born. I just appeared out of my mother in a puff of smoke. I remain party to the dark art of sorcery throughout my childhood. Something told me I was destined to become the world's greatest magician. I had to learn my craft from the great masters, Merlin, Gandalf, Tommy Cooper. I took Tommy Cooper's wisdom to the streets.
Shoes, ground, ground, shoes. Azazaza. Get ready to catch me.
Look, this camera trick won't work if the guys are in shot and stuff. With practice, I became good enough to emulate him, he who must not be named, the true master of the dark arts, Paul Daniels.
You're gonna like this, not a lot, but you'll like it, you bet your ass. Here's my life partner, the lovely Debbie McGee. Now, Debbie, have we ever met before? Say no, David.
No, David.
Now, that's magic. Now, please reveal the bunco booze. I will be trapped inside this bunco booth, far above Pebble Mill Studios, with only three magic balls and just the lovely Debbie McGee for company, with no food or water for the next 85 days. So join us above the below, behind the outside, underground, overground, wumbling free oops upside your head.
I have answered this question about my role in the affair on several occasions previously and will not be drawn into giving my answer again.
On the contrary, Mr. Speaker, I believe the Prime Minister will tell me all I wish to know. Alone at last. Now, where were we?
I assure the Right Honourable Gentleman I had no knowledge of any complicity in this affair. I had no knowledge whatever of any setup. I've only been in government for 7 years. Nobody tells me anything. You can torture me if you like.
Torture you? No. I have a duty not to bullshit you. I have no care at any level as to what you know or don't know. But the proposal to torture the Prime Minister for fun would amuse many people. There is nothing you can do. There is nothing you can say, except hope internal dissent renders my party unelectable. Do you listen to David Miller's Sunday lunchtime show on Classic FM? Mm. Neither do I.
Well, I don't know why I came here tonight. I got the feeling there's something right. I'm so scared in case I fall off my chair. And I'm wondering how I'll get down the stairs. Clowns to the left of me, jokers to the right. Here I am, stuck in the middle with you. Yes, I'm stuck in the middle with you. And I'm wondering what it is I should
not
do.
Not so presentable now, are so we? You look like a fool. A fool.
You're watching ITV1. I'm guessing you're housebound.
And before we see how those scouts get on with their sponsored hop, it's time for our phone-in, and I'm very much up for it today because I'm in a very good mood.
Yes, I know. No wonder you're so chipper. She came along with me to Walthamstow Greyhound Stadium last night, won £8 on the first race. £8!
Is that right?
So I'm not taking you again.
We should get on with it, Denise. Who's first?
Don't you start with the get on with it with me, or I'll be through you like a bag of chips. All right, now just...
Let's hear from our first caller, and I think it's Jane. Hello, Jane in Romford.
Hello, yeah, all right. Yeah, it's about my kids, right? I find it hard to control them, and I've sometimes had to resort to corporal punishment, and I feel bad about that, and I just wonder what you thought, Denise.
Right, well, Jane, what I want to say is that smacking your children, this is a very serious matter, and I don't think that you should do it, because you might strain your wrist, and then that's your lady's darts gone to shite. So we will send you a fact sheet and you can read it. And being from Essex, you'll probably have to read it because you won't have heard us right, seeing as how your ankles are probably blocking your ears up, you old slapper.
You cheeky cow! You come down here and say that!
No bother, love. Only I'd rather do a 20-year stretch in a Turkish jail than set foot down your way. So you get down here and bring the army with you, you scrubber.
I hope that helps, OK? Right, who's next?
Oh. Ian's watching the television.
What is it?
Now, it must be some sort of children's TV franchise.
Isn't he clever? What a clever boy. Can you see any more?
It's a collection of computer-animated characters carefully researched to appeal to small children, offering enormous marketing opportunities for tie-ins and videos.
Do you know their names? Do you know their names?
Is that one called Froggy Log?
Very good. I need three more.
Crikey, you'd better ask some young people.
Do you know any more?
Where's Ross Noble when you need him?
What's that one?
Is it Peter Mandelson?
No, that's Tiddly Widdly.
Ah, so I was right then. Good Lord, so that's what Angus is doing now.
So I thought about it in a very careful way, and I came to the conclusion that bees must therefore support Hull City. Of course, you know, there were many quite Brechtian aspects about Supergran.
Yeah.
So, weather girl of Channel 5, you ordered a starter?
No, I haven't yet.
I recommend the oysters. Always hits the spot. If you receive my meaning. Order some more wine. I'll be right back. Welcome back. Des here. I'm no spring chicken, but if you fancy a spit roast, I've certainly got the dripping. My panel of experts here in the studio includes Tony Gubber, Gubbs, Big Tony, always has a lot to say for himself.
Thanks, Des. Desi, I do think...
Terrific stuff. Tony Green's here as well.
I don't think the microphone's on, Ellie.
Shame about that. You all right, babe?
Well, I suppose I could try...
Horny. Back in a sec. Time for some more sport. Athletics now at the Millennium Mega Bowl in Dalston. Great stuff. If I invite you back for coffee, you'll be up all night.
Well, I can't decaf.
You poor, sweet, innocent girl. Oh, me, winner, fact, okay? Oh, and all these people. Oh, another one. Oh, nothing prepared. Oh, I did my bit, all the rest are dead wood.
And the main news again, Princess Anne's dog has eaten a clown. See, I could say anything, it's so early in the morning, hardly anyone's up. Lorraine Kelly once did it in a skip. I love this job. Right, good morning, you're watching GMTV and it's time to go over to Eamon on the sofa.
Thank you, Penny. It's a quarter to eight, it's GMTV, this is what you're watching, this is what you're waking up to. Today, now, how does he do that? Hi indeed. They've talked about him as the 21st century Houdini. Should be great to meet him. Good morning, Sooty. Now, what do we get with you? You're a magician, you're an illusionist, little yellow glove puppet. What is it with you? What, you're a showman? Oh. Right, and is this part of the show, the mean and moody persona and, you know, oh, what, that's just you. I see. The little eye on the paw, what does that mean? What? Protection? Protection from death? Oh, I see, right. What? Izzy Wizzy, let's get busy, you say? Right. Thank you. What that means is, let's get the finance news with Zippy.